Okay, in the next series of videos, we are going to learn about cube numbers or cubes and cube roots. Now, if you have a look at this picture, it definitely reminds you of something, a very popular puzzle, I would say. This is known as the Rubik's Cube. And one of the reasons, I mean, you are already aware about what a cube is, right? A cube is a geometrical structure. You would have had an introduction about a cube being a geometrical structure that has the same length. Let's say this is the length, then the breadth, and the height, okay? And we know that, so we have L equals B equals H, and therefore you would have also learned that the volume of a cube equals its length into breadth into height, which is actually L multiplied by L multiplied by L, or you could also use B multiplied by B because L, B and H are same, or L to the power 3. So that is what is the volume of a cube. Similarly, for this Rubik's cube, if you want to find out the volume of this cube, you will know that this length here, this is breadth, and this being its height, they are all the same, L into B into H. So the concept of a cube number comes from this. It's a very good analogy. So what is a cube number? A cube number is simply a number that we get by multiplying some another number three times. Three times the number multiplied with itself gives us a number known as a cube number. Now, let us look at the cubes or the cube numbers, whatever you like to call it, from 1 to 10, the common one. So what I have done is I have just made a small table over here so that you can kind of have a look at it. And I would definitely recommend that it is a very good practice to remember these by heart, because they help us a lot when later on we are finding out the other operations, or we are doing the other operations in relation to the cube. So here we have 1 cube is 1, 2's cube, which means 2 times 2 times 2 is 8, 3 cube is 27, that is 3 times 3 times 3 is 27, 4 cube, that is 4 times 4 times 4 is 64, 5 cube is 125, 6 cube is 216, 7 cubed is 343, 8 cubed, that is 8 multiplied by 8 multiplied by 8 is 512, 9 cubed is 729, 10 cubed is 1000. Now, I would like to emphasize that we touched upon the concept of perfect squares, right? Similarly, these numbers here that we have discussed, that is the cube numbers, that is the finding out the cubes for numbers from 1 to 10. And these numbers here that we have got, all these numbers, that is these are known as perfect cubes. Let me just write that down for you. These are known as perfect cubes. And why do we call them perfect cubes? It's precisely the reason that these could be represented as another number multiplied with itself three times. So if, let's try to generalize it, if m could be represented as n by n by n, then we would say that m is a perfect cube. Perfect cube. Okay, now just let us go back to our earlier slide. Okay, how is this Rubik's cube made up of? You can see that it is actually constructed from smaller cubes, right? You can see this is one small cube over here. This whole thing, this is one cube. You can actually look from here as well. This is one entire cube, and it is constructed using these cubes. So how do you think this has been made? Now, so now let us look at how many cubes are required to make this. So L, so in terms of L, we can see in the direction of lengthwise, there are 3 cubes. If you look at breadthwise, again, you can see 1, 2, and 3 cubes, right? 3 cubes. And if you look at the height, so you'll have 1, 2, and 3. So you have 3. So it is 3 times 3 times 3. That gives you 27. So it has 27 cubes. Another way of looking at this is, if you just take this one set, let us take this one set, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. So you have 9 cubes in this one part, and you have this 9 cubes are repeated 3 times, right? This is first time, second time. So this is the second set of 9 cubes, this one, and then this is the third set of 9 cubes. So in that case, it's just a different representation. You would say 9 times 3 is 27. It still comes out to be the same. So this is another, so Rubik cube is actually a perfect cube. Okay, so that was about cubes. Now, before we wrap up this, let us just quickly have a look at some of the properties. One of the thing that straight away comes when we look at this is that there are only 10 perfect cubes, 10 perfect cubes from 1 to 1,000. And if you remember, there were only 10 perfect squares from 1 to 100. So this should ring a bell in your mind as to the properties. So you have increased from 100, we have got it one additional zero. So there are just 10 perfect cubes from 1 to 1,000. The other thing to look out for is the unique patterns. So if you look at the 1 cube, what is the digit in the unit's place? Is 1. For 2, it is 8. For 3, it is 7. For 4, it is 4. For 5, it is 5. 6, it is 6. For 7, the unit digit is 3. For 8, the unit's digit is 2. For 9, it is 9. And for 10, it is 0. Now, you can take up any number and try to take its cube. So the simplest way to calculate a cube is just to find the square of that number and then multiply. For example, if you're supposed to find out the cube of 6, you know 6 times 6 is 36. Okay, so you would actually represent it 6 times 6 times 6, or this is actually the square, so it is 36 multiplied by 6, and when you then you calculate this product, what you will get is 216. So you just take square just for the simplicity and then multiply it by, take the square of that number and then do one more multiplication with that number itself to get the cube. And you can try this for any number. You will find that this unit's digit always hold true, which means the ones, if there is a number that has 1 in the end, its cube will always end in 1. If there is a number that has 2 in n, it will always end in 8. And this is a good pattern to remember. For example, when you just want to figure out whether a particular number might be a cube or not, at least by having a look at it, you can say that, oh, it might be a cube. Of course, we will find out how to really check whether a number is a perfect cube or not. But this is a good example, or this is a good pattern to observe. So that was a quick introduction to cubes. We'll see you in the next video.